The following program is a production of HEW Entertainment and contains views, opinions, commentaries, and content that may offend some subscribers of this show. Listener discretion is advised.
It's that time once again for HEW Entertainment Radio.
And that's all I got to say about that.
Hosted by Jonathan Clark.
Gotta be the man!
You gotta be the man!
Whoa!
Be sure to join us in the live chat room during the show.
Hulkamania is running wild like it's never ran before.
Call us on one of our request lines. If you live in the United States, call us at 1-641-985-7800, box number 3729288. If you're from Canada and would like to call us from 1-647-724-4194, box number 3729288. Long-distance charges may apply in some areas.
I've been the World Heavyweight Champion 10 times.
Or you can always drop us a line at MySpace, myspace.com/HEW Entertainment.
And you will rest in peace.
Emailing us works for you too. Email us HEWWrestling@hotmail.com.
I am a wrestling god.
J.B.L. J-B-L.
And now, without any further ado, here is your host of HEW Entertainment Radio on the official website of HEW Entertainment, Jonathan Clark.
The champ is here!
HEW Entertainment Radio is inviting you to comment on our video blogs, join the conversation, and like us.
Comment on our video blogs, join the conversation, and like us.
So what are you waiting for? Log on and listen now.
Don't miss out on any of the action. Download our app on the App Store, Google Play, and the official website of HEW Entertainment. Once you download and install it, you'll get caught up on news, YouTube videos, and more. Download it now.
I really want to stop, but I just got the taste for it. I feel like I could fly like the boy on the moon. So honey, hold my hand, you like making me wait. Feel like I could die walking up to the room. Oh yeah. Late night watching television, but how'd we get in this position? It's way too soon. I know this isn't love, but I need to tell you something. Everything you say is a sweet revelation. All I wanna do is get into your head. That we could stay alone, you and me and the temptation. Sipping on your lips, hanging on by a thread. Baby, late night watching television, but how'd we get in this position? It's way too soon. I know this isn't love, but I need to tell you something.
Me too.
I really, 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 really like you. And I want you. Do you want me? you could keep them. I don't know how to act or if I should be leaving. I'm running out of time, going out of my mind. I need to tell you something. Yeah, I need to tell you something.
That song makes me think about Carmella and her promising WWE debut. Off of that, I'm your host, Jonathan Clark, with Carly Rae Jepsen's I Really Like You. I like that song because it puts me in mind of Carmella and her very promising future for WWE and all the fans. But off of that, we are counting it down to Monday Night Raw and the fallout of the 2016 unprecedented, very unpredictable WWE draft. Really excited to see where both women's divisions for Raw and SmackDown are going to be heading in the fallout of the draft. We have people like Carmella, Alexa Bliss, Naomi, Becky Lynch, Natalya, all drafted to SmackDown Live less than 24 hours after Monday Night Raw. SmackDown Live on Tuesday nights now. Really excited about that. A feud actually on NXT took place between Alexa Bliss and Carmella some time ago. And if you have never seen the videos of this feud between Carmella and Alexa Bliss, you should check it out because it was really cool seeing these two tear it up. And it's kind of cool seeing them make their debuts around the same time. Really excited to see where we go from here. If you're wondering if I was ever a fan of Carmella, this just did not happen overnight. For Jonathan Clark, I have always been a really big Carmella fan, and I don't really know what the reason was for me being a really big Carmella fan. There was nothing really special about Carmella that stood out. You know, you had your Trish Stratuses, you had your Stacy Keiblers, your Tori Wilsons, your Rena Marrows even, that had things that defined them and separated them from everybody within the divisions they were competing in for whatever organization at the time. And they were just people that stood out. But Carmella's really not doing anything really special that's really standing out to me. I'm just choosing her as someone who seems to have somewhat of a very promising future. For some reason, I was always a really big fan of Carmella. There was nothing really special about her character, nothing really stood out. Yeah, she had a bit of an accent, a bit of an attitude, a bit of spunk on NXT. We got that from her feud with Alexa Bliss and Bayley. You know, those were pretty interesting matches, great matches that you can see on YouTube all the time whenever you want to, and on demand on the WWE Network. But there was nothing really special that ever stood out to me about Carmella. She was just one of those women that just kind of stood out. Kind of just showed up and, you know, you just kind of knew she had promise from the first time you looked at her. Nothing really standing out about her. Now, I do recommend that you check out some of her stuff on YouTube from her days on NXT. Feuds with the likes of Alexa Bliss and Bayley will really put into perspective for you just how good Carmella is. Her toughness is something that really stands out if you want to choose one quality about Carmella that I think is really going to get her to the distance in WWE and really bring the best of her out. Her toughness is something that really stands out. I got that from the feuds that we saw between Carmella, Alexa Bliss, and Bayley. Really excited to see what happens there. I can't see Carmella winning the WWE Women's Championship anytime soon. That's going to take some time. You know, to say that she's going to win that Women's Championship would kind of be a ridiculous prediction to make right now because we really haven't seen much in the way of wrestling or much of a character breaking through for Carmella. I mentioned, you know, the possibility of her possibly managing someone some time ago, possibly the likes of a Daniel Bryan character in the way of an AJ. That would be a great way to kind of break her into the business and kind of write a storyline for her over time. I just don't see her winning the Women's Championship in the way of a Sasha Banks or a Gail Kim, if you even want to go back that far, in 2004 when Gail Kim made her WWE debut, actually, and I think it was actually Toronto, winning a Battle Royal to become Women's Champion. It's not going to happen for Carmella overnight like it has many people. I think what it comes down to is your work ethic and how much you can impress the officials in WWE, the creative team, and I think it's going to be a long time before Carmella actually impresses anyone to get her a Women's Championship right at some point down the road. What kind of role will she have with WWE? I have this here in my notes. I just mentioned, you know, possibly managing a character
the way of a Daniel Bryan, probably not as effectively as what AJ did as the valet manager of Daniel Bryan, but I can see her managing some kind of character kind of similar out of that of Daniel Bryan, CM Punk, probably even a Kane kind of character with how Kane's been involved in romance storylines for years. We've known that. It'd be customary of Kane, so it wouldn't surprise me none if we saw her in kind of an AJ Lee role from the earlier years of AJ's career. I would love to see that, because that would allow Carmella to show us what she can do on the microphone, how she can stand out in a storyline, probably more effectively than what she's doing right now. Because if you go back to Carmella's debut on the first SmackDown Live in the fall of the draft, she just kind of showed up at the end of the Becky Lynch Natalya match, nothing really special about Carmella coming out with a hat on and a microphone like they all did, like Naomi, like Alexa Bliss did, expecting big things from all of them. And then the final debut was actually Eva Marie, so you would expect Eva Marie to be the one really to stand out from all the debuts we've seen recently taking place in the SmackDown Live Women's Division. But that does not mean that Carmella can't expect big things from her, really expecting something special to happen for her. What? At this point, I don't know if it's anything. It's going to be in the role of a manager, probably even a GM kind of role for Carmella down the road once she learns her craft more effectively and can apply that to what she's going to be doing. You know, you can kind of make that promising prediction for Carmella and kind of get away with it.